안녕하세요, tout le monde. 我是 you. So today I will be sharing with you how to find a job in Japan. Many of you asked me this question before, and many of you have said, I want to move to Japan, but I don't know how to look for a job. I don't know how to start. So today I will share with you some of the job options in Japan, especially for those of you who don't speak Japanese. This is actually the first video of a new series I'm planning.I want to share with you how to move to Japan and how to live in Japan. So if you do have questions, make sure to leave it in the comment section below and I'll make sure to go through them and film them for you. Also, I just want to say that I've been living in Tokyo for about a year. Anything I say is based on my own experience and research. So if you have any extra information or you think something I said might be wrong, don't hesitate to leave me a comment down below so that others can look at it as well. All right, let's get into today's video. To begin with, let's talk about teaching jobs. This is definitely the most common option for anybody who wants to move to Japan, and it's probably the easiest job to find. But I also want to tell you to keep watching because I will be talking about non-English teaching jobs toward the second part of the video, so make sure to stay tuned. There are several options to get an English teaching job in Japan. First, there are programs like JET,which take care of basically the whole process. You send in an application, then you do interviews, and then once you're accepted, they will take care of the visa process and help with your moving process as well. For English teaching jobs and probably jobs in general, this is probably the most convenient way of moving to Japan. And of course, there are downsides to this as well because you have to be accepted into the program and they're pretty selective. And once you're accepted,you may not be able to choose where exactly you will go in Japan. They may send you to a more remote area of Japan that you may not be interested in moving to. I have friends who work for the program and their complaints are usually the work hours are really, really long because you do have to work full-time and usually you are placed in a regular Japanese school, meaning your work environment will be Japanese. So even though you're not required to know Japanese to apply for this job, you could feel a little bit isolated since your coworkers might only be speaking Japanese. But on a day-to-day basis, you won't have any problem without speaking Japanese because the agency will take care of any problem you may encounter and they will do orientation as well. I won't talk too much about this because I don't have the personal experience of doing the program, but it is definitely one of the most popular way to get a job in Japan. So make sure you do your research if you're interested. If you are still interested in English teaching jobs, but you want a little more freedom and choose where you want to go, then you can look into getting a job at Aikaiwa. Aikaiwa is like a private English conversation school, kind of like an after-school program. And usually, depending on the school and what programs they have, you can work there as full-time staff or part-time. I am a part-time teacher, and this is mainly because I am on spousal visa, and I can only work up to 28 hours per week. So the kind of jobs you might want to look into or the options you might have may be limited to the kind of visa that you have. The pros of working this kind of job is you may have more freedom to choose where you want to go, which school you want to teach at, what kind of environment you want to put yourself in, and your coworkers might all be English-speaking people because they're all teachers. So you may be able to make more friends and have kind of a social life at work and not feel as isolated. And also if you're a part-time worker, obviously your workload may be lighter. Also, you may have less responsibility and therefore get less stressed at work because what you do is kind of limited. But again, like I said, I'm only talking about my own experience and may be different depending on the school you work at. But generally speaking, Aikaiwa has a more relaxed environment and a lot of times you can wear whatever you want and the materials are usually more fun and entertaining. But of course, there's downsides as well. A lot of the Aikaiwa places require you to already have a visa in order to work there. Some might sponsor you for a full-time work visa, but a lot of times they require you to have a certain status in Japan already and they may not provide you withhousing or medical insurance or any sort of perks, so you may have to get those yourself. So whether you choose to work for a JET program or Eikaiwa. There are definitely pros and cons on both sides, and you kind of have to choose what's more important to you. I briefly talked about how to find a job for JET program. You just have to apply to the program and do interviews. But for Eikaiwa, there are different ways of getting a job, and I will talk more about the resources you need to use later in this video. But in general, you can look for yourself, do your research online, just email your resume, upload your resume on certain websites, and also maybe contact recruiters that work for English teaching companies that may be looking for teachers. And I don't know how popular Craigslist is in Tokyo, but I actually found the job I have pretty easily, and I'm quite happy with my job. So I definitely recommend using it, even though it may not be the first thing people use to look for jobs in Tokyo. You might be thinking, I don't want to teach little kids for the rest of my life and teach the same thing over and over again. It doesn't feel appealing to me. There are a couple of career advancement options for you. After you teach for a while, depending on what kind of degrees you have, you might be able to get a college teaching job. And college teaching jobs are great because your workload may be less, and the students are more mature, obviously, because they're adults, and their levels will be higher because they have already had previous English education. And of course, the pay will be much better. And I think college professors in Japan are treated really, really well, and they're paid well. They have lots of nice perks. And of course, you get a long break during the summer and winter, which is really, really nice. If you're interested in this option and want to become a college professor, then you will need to get a master's degree. So this is definitely a great option for those of you who want to move to Japan and plan on staying here for a long time. Another option after English teaching is to become an admin. So all these English programs, or Eikaiwa even, they will have management teams. Even if you don't speak Japanese, a lot of them have English-speaking staff, especially with your experience as a teacher before. You'll be really valuable to the company. And of course, this is also for those of you who want to remain here for a long period of time, because it will probably take you a few years to get to a managing position. Now let's talk about some jobs that are not about teaching English or not about teaching at all. Interestingly, I don't see a lot of people talking about this because I think generally people assume that if you want to do any sort of job without having to teach English, you have to know Japanese. And that's not really the case because there are so many expats in Japan that have a pretty good demand of English speaking staff for different things. A few options that I have seen when I was job searching are media related staff, IT engineers, lawyers, recruiters, and also corporate or business staff. It's definitely not limited to these jobs, but the demand will be different depending on your field of study or work. So there are a few different ways to look for a job that's related to your field. One is to work with a recruiter. If you have been working for a while, you might have gotten calls from recruiters. If you work with a recruiter in your own country, they may not have many of the job openings in the Asia market. So you might say, I don't know a recruiter in Asia. What you could do is contact the recruiter in your country, and they might refer you to somebody who works in Asia. So this way you will get a lot more options. You might hear firsthand which company has an opening and then start the process right away. The second option is to move to a different branch of your company. If you work for a big company that has a branch in Japan, you might look for an inside transfer. It may not always work, but a lot of times they might have an opening soon, or they're looking to expand their international branches. And for those of you who don't work for a big company like that, you can try to look for a position at a big brand company like Google or Rakuten that needs a lot of international staff. The third way is for those of you who are still in school or maybe just graduated, and that is looking for an internship. There are a lot of companies that do internships in Japan, and it might be a short-term internship, but it definitely opens some doors for you. So if you're interested, apply for the internship and see if you can get a job after your internship. Because I think a lot of times when you want to move overseas, the important thing and the most difficult thing is to open that door. So once you have the experience of working in Japan, no matter how short or long that is, it becomes a lot easier to find a more steady job in the future. So for those of you who are eligible to do an internship, definitely look into that. And finally, if you need to look for a job yourself, I will provide a list of useful websites down in the info box below. A few popular ones are Gaijinpot, Japan Times, which is like a newspaper, but they have a lot of online posting for jobs. And also, like I mentioned before, Craigslist, it's really useful. You can actually find all kinds of jobs on there, and the postings are in English. Many of them might require Japanese, but there are definitely options that you can look into. Since there are so many different types of jobs you can do for non-English teaching options, so I can't really go into specific jobs or titles, but here are some options on how to start your job search. And make sure to leave your comments and questions down below. I will try to answer them. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And stay tuned for the rest of the series, where I'll talk about lots of useful information that you will want to know if you want to move to Japan or want to live in Japan. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more from me in the future, and I'll see you next time. Bye!